Happy evening to all. As we know that our Little Flower group of institution encourage our students in lot of talents. Among that, one of the event is No World Juniors. Let them be themselves, an exclusive online program which explores the student talent, ability and their thoughts. First come talent table. We are here to showcase the best of best talents that our students ready to offer.
Hello friends, my name is Joya Antaraj. I am studying grade 2. Today I am going to do an experiment. Experiment name is air and water. Things needed are bowl, water bottle and spoon. Take the water bottle and take the spoon. Make the hole. See, when there is no air pressure, no water comes out. When there is air pressure, water comes out. I hope you enjoyed my experiment. Thank you.
Hi guys, I am Shreyasen from 4th B. Now I am going to do one magic for you. It is cards magic. Let's start.
Second row. Okay, done.
Card as been.
Second row.
Now which row, ma'am?
Third row. Yes, correct.
Thank you, bye-bye.
Next come spotlight. In student spotlight, we focus on student skill, talent and drive discovering what makes them succeed. Our school student SP Sai Pramesh of grade 3 has won second place in Abacus single digit category held on 14 November 2023, and he is champion of champion in International Talent Examination Batch 2, which was conducted by RABA International Cultural Academy. Now it's time to hear Kutty story. Short moral stories for kids are the best way to teach valuable life lessons to kids. It's a fun and easy way through which children can understand complex concept. Let's hear the Little Flower Kutty's Kutty story.
Hi, I am Tanushri of Class 1. I'm going to tell one story. The story name is Goose and the Golden Eggs. Once a farmer had a goose. It put golden eggs every day. The man sold the eggs, became too rich. He was a greedy father. He wanted all the eggs at the same time. So he killed the goose. But he found only one egg. Then he poor mother, don't be greedy. Thank you.
Now I'll tell you about one small story. crow. Once there was a crow. He was very thirsty. He flew here and there in search of water, but he found no water. At last, he went to a garden. There he saw a pitcher. The water in the pitcher was very low. He could not drink it. He saw here and there. He saw some small stones in the garden. He flew and put that pieces of stones in the pitcher. The water rose up. He drank it and flew away happily. The moral of the story is necessity is mother of invention. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Next come Cartoon Corner. Knowingly or unknowingly, cartoons and respective cartoon characters have played an important role in mending our personality. Here are some of the cartoon characters that have created a space in some or the other corners of our memory. Implementing circular classroom table is a wonderful way to socialize early learners and encourage collaboration among teacher and student. Here comes the discussion about an interesting thing. Let's watch it.
Hello students, what are you all doing?
Drawing, ma'am.
Drawing. Let me see what you are drawing.
I am butterfly.
Very good. So this is three. Very good. There. Very good. Very good. So now just Riyoj, can you tell me what are you using for drawing?
Pencil and pencil waste.
Very good. So we are using pencil, you are using pencil and pencil waste. Do you all know there is a cool story about pencils?
No, ma'am.
No. So let me tell you. So long, long ago, there was a shepherd in England, so who went for grazing their sheep. So they found some impression on the sheep. So that is how they found the graphite. So graphite is the material which we use inside our pencil. Right? Gugan, will you tell me how pencils are made?
Pencil is made up of graphite inside a wooden case. It is easy to write and it is clean for hands.
Sadhana, who made the first pencil?
Nicholas Jack was content the year 1795.
Do you know pencil manufacturers use a few combination of letters? Right? Why do we use them?
To describe the quality of graphite in pencil.
Yes, they describe the quality of the graphite. They use such combination of letters. Can you tell me what are the different combinations?
HB and BBB.
Harshit, will you tell me what is HB stands for?
HB stands for hot black.
Very good. Dheera, can you tell me what is BB?
BB stands for very black.
Very good. Who is the most popular pencil manufacturer in India?
Hindustan Pencils.
So, Riyoj, can you tell me what are the different grade levels in the pencils?
HB, 2B, 3B, 4B, till 9B.
Very good. So, you can see a picture here. So, these are the different grade levels of pencils. So, starting from HB, your darkness of the pencil increases in B. So, whereas in H, your darkness decreases while you have a H pencils. So F stands for firm, so which is a moderate pencils. So mostly while writing we use what type of pencil? So these are all HB pencils. Okay, right. So can a pencil write underwater?
Yes, since the graphite is insoluble, so the pencil is used for writing underwater.
Very good. Can you guess how many words can one pencil write?
45,000 words.
Sarvesh, can you tell me what is this?
This is the recycled pencil which is given in our school Little Flower group of institution.
Sarvesh, what is a recyclable pencil?
The recycled pencil are made of waste papers and newspapers.
Very good. Can you tell me what are the different types of pencil available?
Mechanical pencil, color pencil, charcoal pencil, graphite pencil.
How many of you seen Nanman movie? Yes. Okay. Can anyone of you tell me what was the discussion going on in the Nanban movie?
It was a pencil which were used in space.
Why can't we use pen in space?
No, ma'am, because in space do not have gravity.
Very good. As Sadhana told, we can't use a normal pen in space. Do you know why? So there is no gravity, as she told. So as there is no gravitational force in space, so the ink in the cartridge or in the normal pen will not flow down or up. So that's why we use pencils in those days.
Even today, the pencil is used on space, ma'am.
That was a good question, Gugan. Actually, it was no. Nowadays, we are using space pens. So we have a space pens which the astronauts are using. So we'll talk about pens in the next session. So before winding up, let me show you what are all the artwork done by our students. First, we'll have Harshit. Hope you all enjoyed this session, students. It was informative, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Shade self. Reading improve your vocabulary and your knowledge of the world. The plan is to select and read a book. There is so much amazing stuff out there. Now I call upon my friend P. Moshika of Grade 5 Little Flower Fusion School to share her thoughts about her favorite book.
Of Craig Fay from Eating Flower Fusion School. Now I am going to tell about Book Review of The Psychology of Money by Morgan Housel. All of us dream of being a big bank balance in our accounts, but we still tend to be on the verge of being broke. This is a major issue when we are students. One of the big reasons is we don't know any tips to manage our money and finances efficiently. But this money worry ceases when you pick this book off the shelf. This book contains 252 pages. This book is a collection of 19 short stories. It aims to guide students promoting a healthy connection with money, allowing us to make knowledgeable financial decisions and set meaningful goals. It's one of the best books to read for students designed to improve their financial literacy and make wise choices with their money. It incredible book that teaches the reader how humans behave when dealing with money, how pride, fear, greed and anxiety can influence a person and make them commit a mistake when money is the subject. I would like to share few lines, few pages from the book. Planning is important, but the most important part of every plan is to plan on the plan, not going according to plan. Doing well with money has a little to do with how smart you are and a lot to do with how you behave. I hope this book is best for students to handle money for future. Thank you.
Watching movie makes us more active. Make time for loved one, learning new hobby and skill and improve our mental health. Now, it's movie time.
จะได้อะไรถ้าเขาทำแบบนี้ทุกวัน
อ
เขาจะไม่ได้อะไรเลยไม่ได้รวยขึ้นไม่ได้ออกทีวีไม่มีใครรู้จักไม่ได้มีชื่อเสียงที่มากขึ้นเพราะสิ่งที่เขาได้คือได้แค่ความรู้สึกได้เห็นความสุขได้เข้าใจได้ความรักได้ในสิ่งที่เงินซื้อไม่ได้ได้โลกที่สวยงามกว่าเดิมในชีวิตคุณอะไรคือสิ่งที่คุณต้องการมากที่สุด
Hi, I'm G. Sanjana from 4C. Today, I watch a very motivational movie.It's good. On that movie, I learned to help others.
Hi everyone. My name is Ahia. I'm studying third standard.
What we understood from this story, he was not doing all those things for publicity. And he was not richer either. But he receives happy emotions by seeing others happy. This is a very good motivation video.Where each and everyone should act like him. Having money or helping yourself won't give you happiness, but sharing your happiness and helping others can definitely bring change to your life. Be kind. Being kind is not going to cost anything in your life. Let's all start it from now on. Thank you.
I have learned about helping others make good future.
In this video, we learn we should help others and we will get happiness.
If we help others, we get happiness and enjoy the life.
Zero to Hero, a situation in which someone changes quickly from being unpopular to being a very successful one.Let's come to know about the personality who transformed from zero to hero.
Greetings everyone. Let me introduce myself. I'm Anas Vedish and I'm a student of LFFS. For the next couple minutes, I'm going to tell the success story of a successful person in life. Okay, first of all, let me know a thing. How many of you people like chickens, especially the fried ones? Yep, he's also related to them. Colonel Sanders. Colonel Sanders was born in 1980.His father died at his age of 5. At the age of 10, he got his first job in a local farm. Over the next 28 years, Sanders would take on an incredible number of different jobs across the South America. These included a brief stint in the US Army, streetcar conductor, railroad fireman, secretary, insurance salesman, and etc. As he left youth and entered middle age, Sanders felt thatHe could never achieve the success in life which his hard work demanded. Eventually, he ran a gas station in Corbin, Kentucky. There, he started cooking and selling meals for the travelers who stopped in the gas station. This leads him to start his first restaurant. His winning streak even grew in 1939. After a lot of struggles and blasts, he firmly coined a name, Kentucky Fried Chickens, for his restaurant, which reminds us crispy chicken and a man in white suit. Any guesses? Yes, he is none other than Colonel Harvard Sanders, the king of the great kingdom called KFC. Thank you.
Now it's riddle time. Riddles can be a wonderful challenge which helps to motivate children to think in a different angle, which improves the creative thinking. Let's begin.
Good evening to all. I am Lakshmi Priya of Class 4. Are you ready? Let's begin the riddles. Number 1. There is a one-story house in which everything is yellow. Yellow walls, yellow doors, yellow furniture. What color are the stairs? Answer. There aren't any. It is a one-story house. Number 2. What has many keys but never opens a single lock? Answer. Keyboard. Number 3. I never ask questions but always answer. Who am I? Answer. A doorbell. Number 4. Name 3 consecutive days by without naming any of the 7 days of the week. Answer. Yesterday, today, tomorrow. Number 5. There is only one word in the dictionary that's spelled wrong. What it is? Answer. Wrong. Number 6. How many months in a year have 28 days? Answer. All the 12 months. Number 7. If you take 4 apples from 5 apples, how many do you have? Answer. 4 apples. Number 8. You go at red and stop at green. What is it? Answer. A watermelon. Number 9. You see me once in June, twice in November, and not in May. What it is? Answer. Letter E. Number 10. I shoot but never kill. What it is? A camera. Thank you.
Fun games. Playing games is one of the important part of learning process. Yay! It's game time.
எப்படியோ அவங்கள சமாளிச்சு அனுப்பிட்டேன். ஷின்சான் இன்னைக்கு எப்பதான் வழியில வருவ? ஷின்சான், உன்னோட பஸ் போயிடுச்சு. எங்க
அங்க யாருகிட்டமா பேசிட்டு இருக்கீங்க?
நீ இங்க என்ன பண்ணிட்டு இருக்க?
இன்னைக்கு எனக்கு நிறைய ஃப்ரீ டைம் இருக்குமா, அதான் ஹீரோ சாப்பிடுறதுக்கு சாப்பாடு போட்டுட்டு இருக்கேன்.
வாவ் ஷின்சான், நல்ல வேலை எல்லாம் பண்ற.
உங்க வெயிட் தாங்கள போல இருக்குமா.
நான் ஒண்ணும் அவ்வளவு வெயிட் கிடையாது.
அம்மா, நீங்க மறந்தே போயிட்டீங்க. ஹிமாவாரி என்ன கூட்டிட்டு வரலையே?
வேற வழியே இல்ல.
ஹலோ டாக்ஸி.
டாக்ஸிலாம் ஒண்ணு தேவையில்ல, நாம நடந்தே போலாம்.
என்னது நம்ம நிலைமை இப்படி ஆயிடுச்சு,
கால் வலி தாங்க முடியலையே.
இதுக்குதான் ஒழுங்கா டாக்ஸியை பிடிக்கிறேன்னு சொன்னேன், என் பேச்சை கேட்டா தானே அனுபவிங்க.
ஷின்சான் கரெக்டான டைமுக்கு நீ எழுந்தாலே போதும். மழையா? அது சரி, நீ ஸ்கூலுக்கு போகாம இருக்கிறதுக்கு என்னெல்லாம் சொல்லுவியோ அதெல்லாம் சொல்லுவேன், எனக்கும் தெரியும். வா.
அம்மா.
என்னாச்சு?
நான் அதை உங்ககிட்ட எப்படி சொல்லுவேன்?
என்ன, எதையாவது மறந்துட்டியா? எதுவா இருந்தாலும் பரவாயில்ல, நீ வா. இதுக்கப்புறம் திரும்ப வீட்டுக்கெல்லாம் போக முடியாது.
நிஜமாவா?
முன்னாடி போக போறியா இல்லையா?
சரி, நான் போறேன். நீங்க தான் துணிய வெளிய காயப்பட்டீங்க, அது நனைஞ்சுகிட்டு இருக்கோம்.
கொஞ்சம் ஆயிடுச்சு, வேற ஒண்ணும்
இல்ல. பஞ்சர் ஆன விஷயத்த சொல்லவே இல்லையே,
அத பத்தி அவங்க உங்ககிட்ட கேட்டாங்களா? இன்னும் என்னெல்லாம் நடக்க போகுதோ?
கவலைப்படாதீங்கம்மா, மழை பெஞ்சா ரெயின் கோட்ல இருக்கிற அழுக்கெல்லாம் போக்கிடும்.
கார் வருதுன்னு முன்னாடி என்கிட்ட சொல்லிருக்கலாம்ல ஷின்சான். ஷின்சான் இல்ல, எங்க போயிட்டு இருக்க? நில்ல ஷின்சான்.
எனக்கு மழையில நனையவே பிடிக்காது, என்னுடைய ஹாஸ்டல் எல்லாம் பாழா போயிடும்.
நானும் அப்படிதான், மழை நேரங்கள்ல வீட்டை விட்டு வெளியே வரவே மாட்டேன்.
ஹலோ சார், நாங்க இந்த பக்கமா போகணும்.
இங்க தண்ணி கொஞ்சம் அதிகமா இருக்கு, இன்னைக்கு ஒரு நாள் மட்டும் நீங்க கொஞ்சம் சுத்தி போறீங்களா?
இன்னைக்கு எனக்கு நாளே சரியில்லை.
ஆமாமா, இப்படி மலை ஏற விட்டுட்டாங்களே.
இது எல்லாத்துக்கும் காரணம் நீதான் ஷின்சான்.
ஒரு
வழியா வந்துட்டோம். வாங்க. சாரி, நாங்க வரதுக்கு கொஞ்சம் லேட் ஆயிடுச்சு.
அம்மா வேலை நடக்கவே முடியல.
அவங்க உன்னை எதுவும் கேக்கல.
விஷயம் என்னன்னா, பசங்க எல்லாரும் இப்பதான் வீட்டுக்கு கிளம்பினாங்க. இன்னைக்கு ஸ்கூல் மத்தியானமே முடிஞ்சு போயிடுச்சு. நாங்க டைரியில நோட் பண்ணி அனுப்பியிருந்தோமே, நீங்க அதை பார்க்கவே இல்லையா?
டைரியிலயா?
Thank you all for your patience. I hope everyone loved it. I will catch you on the next episode. Take care. Bye-bye.